Michael.
All right. Good morning. thank you. We really appreciate you taking the time to come to Seattle. I know for a lot of you, particularly from the East Coast, it's quite a distance, but it is, it's a great town, and as Alex and his team did a great job of ordering up this great weather, so really appreciate it. I am going to take you, that does say Vice President of Marketing. I am actually going to take you through the sales piece of this. Many of you have already seen seen this slide before. We've used it in Miami, and also we use it a lot internally. This is really kind of explaining the industry and what's been happening. For Kia, we have basically a baseline forecast, which is in line with J.D. Power and Global Insights. We're forecasting about a 10 million industry for 2010. But for internal purposes, we also do some scenario planning where we are constantly evaluating, okay, what's going to happen with the market if it does fall an additional 20%? Or what's going to happen to the market and how are we going to respond if it goes up 20%? But right now, we're kind of in this ballpark of about 10 million units this year. For us, for Kia, we've actually had a really good year so far. While down, we're not down nearly as much as the industry. At 36.5%, we're down about 6.8%. A lot of people have questioned how have we been able to do that. A lot of it is driven by our aggressive marketing. In January and February, when a lot of OEMs pull back from their marketing, we were heavy in television particularly. A lot of others were dark. So that helped us get off to a pretty good start. The new Soul obviously has contributed to our sales growth this year. And then in May as well, in the month of May, than we ever have in Kia's history. So that just shows we're being very aggressive in this marketplace. We recognize that there are consumers still out buying our buying vehicles, and we want them to be aware of what Kia has to offer. And because of this, we've been able to gain some significant market share this year. We're up about 47% versus last year when we were about 2.1%, and right now we're at about 3.1%. This slide here just kind of shows what's been going on over the last year. As you can see, the precipitous fall from some of our competition, whereas we've been pretty steady in terms of our sales. And again, that's just being driven by our aggressive marketing in the marketplace. This is an interesting interesting slide for me when I first saw it. Kia has traditionally done well in kind of the smaller markets and the rural markets where we have, which is really where Honda and Toyota do exceptionally well. But when we were in Miami, we told you that the Soul was going to help us to break into some of these markets. In fact, we showed you a slide here that said these are the markets where we think Soul is really going to do well. Northeast, Miami, areas in Texas, California particularly, Pacific Northwest. And Soul's only been on the market for about 2.5 months now, and we are actually seeing significant sales coming from these markets. So we're making good inroads into areas that have traditionally been held by Toyota and Honda. And we believe that the Forte is really going to help us continue to make inroads into those areas. So our traditional markets of the smaller markets and the rural markets, we're able to hold our sales and share there, and now we're starting to break into some of these other markets. This slide here just kind of shows some of our market share gains by region, doing really well in the Northeast. We're up 81% year to date. The South, which has traditionally been Kia's stronghold, is up 31%. The Midwest, which is, as you all know, predominantly dominated by the domestics, we've done well here as well, 25% up. And even in the very competitive and Asian import dominated, particularly the Japanese dominated West, we're up 22%. So we feel pretty good about both our product and our dealer network and the share gains that we've made. This slide here is interesting, and we'll breeze through it pretty quickly. We're all looking at it when we got it from the sales team. But really what it's saying is that the credit quality of our consumers is increasing and improving as well. The green line here is last year. The blue line is this year. And what we're seeing here is an increase in terms of the people that are able to qualify for low APR credit versus where we've been in the past. So we're seeing a new customer come into our showroom, and those customers have higher quality credit scores, so we're able to get them better financing. So very good news there. Now, for us, our timing could not be better. We've launched the Soul, as you very well know, been very well received in the marketplace, both from the media standpoint and from the consumers. And now we've got this absolutely fantastic vehicle, the Forte. But the story continues, showing a little sneak peek here. We actually showed you this in Miami. This is the Sorrento replacement that will be coming later this year out of our plant in West Point, Georgia. Now, speaking of West Point, we're on track, continuing our investment there, start building vehicles later this year. But what we're really trying to show is here is that we're not just here to sell cars, but we're also here to help build kind of the U.S., well, build our infrastructure to help us continue the growth that we've experienced. Back in 2007, we opened our corporate campus in Orange County, California, with a $100 million investment. We opened our design center last year, $35 million investment, and we're continuing our investment here in the U.S. with a $1 billion investment in the state of Georgia. We ran this ad in USA Today back in January just to kind of let people know that we are here and are supporting the U.S. economy. Speaking of our investment in Georgia, as I mentioned, on track to begin, start building vehicles later this year. We've actually now, all of the equipment is in the plant and being tested. We did our first roof panel stamped in April, and the first complete body weld and offline of the vehicle was done in March. And as Alex mentioned, we're going to be very excited to have you guys come down to Georgia in the near future to show off what we have there. It really is a phenomenal plant. And the reason I think will be an absolute hit from a manufacturing standpoint is we've taken a lot of the lessons learned from our investments in places like Slovakia and in China and taken all of the best practices there and put them in our plant here. This will be the most technologically advanced plant within the whole Hyundai and Kia network. We've got a lot of process improvements, just some of them listed there. But we're also taking a new approach to just-in-time manufacturing. The suppliers on the pad are chosen for maximum efficiencies and quick problem-solving capabilities. And we're also, we have less suppliers on the pad, which is actually seems counterintuitive to what you'd think we'd want to do. But for the most part, most of our suppliers are now located within a 20-mile radius, so we can have easy access to the parts that we need. So very exciting there. We look forward to having you down there again in the near future. Now, mentioned Soul, saw many of you in Miami, and you had a great opportunity to drive the vehicle. Went on sale just shortly thereafter. We have just been blown away by the success of the sales results here. This is the May 2009 sales. We sold 3,855 Souls. We almost outsold Scion XB and Nissan Cube combined. We were about 100 units short. So now, in fairness to the Nissan Cube, it was their first month in the market, but we do believe we have a very competitive product in this highly competitive segment. So very exciting for us. Now, you were in Miami. We told you that the Soul was going to kind of transcend the segments. We thought we would see people coming from all different segments, and in fact, the green bars here show that is the case. This is actual data. for the soul. We're seeing people come from the traditional compact and mid-size car segments. But if you look in some of these other places, we're seeing them come from MPVs, which probably speaks to the storage capacity and the roominess of the vehicle, seeing them come from mid-size CUVs and SUVs. Interesting enough, even a few coming from full-size pickups, those people that bought them a couple years ago when gas was cheap and now decided that they still need roominess and efficiency. But we expect that the Forte will also kind of transcend a similar pattern to the Soul. Forte here in the red, obviously because it is the largest segment in the marketplace, most of the buyers will come from compact segment and midsize, but we do expect to see them coming from a lot of other segments as well. Now, speaking of Forte, the real reason why you're here, again, very excited to have you get in and drive this vehicle. It's absolutely fantastic. We announced pricing just recently. We will have three series, the first being our LX, which will start at $13,695, very well equipped, and Fred Akins, who's going to come up after me, will speak to it. Then we've got the EX, which starts at $15,795, and then we have the SX, which starts at $17,195. Now, what's really important here is that all Forte models are going to be equipped with really cool technology like Bluetooth, auxiliary input jack, things like Sirius satellite radio, and of course, they are all of this will be backed up by our 10-year, 100,000-mile warranty. So with that, the real reason why you're here is to learn about the product, and with that, I'll turn it over to Fred Akins.